All right, so you need this nap after you eat, or maybe you get sluggish mid-afternoon and you're trying to figure out what you can do because it's interrupting your production. Okay, so we're going to talk about that today. A lot of countries take siestas. They take a nap after they eat, and that includes Mexico and the Philippines and Spain, Italy, and even certain parts of France. And so I really needed a nap in the past after I ate. I was always tired. I didn't know why. I thought I just needed more caffeine because that didn't work because I couldn't sleep that night. So I had a big problem with fatigue in general. In the morning, I had a hard time waking up. It'd take me until 11 o'clock until I woke up, and then I would eat lunch and then have to take a nap. So it was just driving me crazy. So the term for this, the medical term, is called postprandial somnolence. So post means after, prandial means related to eating or a meal, and somnolence means drowsy or sleepy. You're sleepy or drowsy after a meal. There are multiple reasons for this. I want to cover all of them. There's some theories that may or may not be true. I'm just going to give you all of the information so then you can have a plan to not be so tired after you eat. Recently, I did a trip in France and Italy to look at various farms and actually do some research that I'm doing on soil. And I looked at their soils, I looked at their farming methods, and I was quite amazed. And I had a chance to kind of see what both countries eat in the morning and at lunch. There were some really healthy foods that people eat. In fact, the quality is much higher there than it is in America. But of course, there's some added things that kind of mess everything up. You know what I'm talking about? All the sugar, the sweets, the pasta, the pizza, the baguettes, the croissants, the bread, the wine, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So what happens at this lunchtime when you add carbohydrates, okay? Especially if you're doing a high carb diet. And this could even apply if you're doing a high protein with high carbs. It's like the worst case scenario. So what's happening is you're elevating blood sugar levels and you're elevating insulin levels. And initially, maybe you can handle it, okay, and you don't get tired. But over time, your body will start developing insulin resistance. And what happens with insulin resistance in the cell is that it starts resisting not just insulin, but the fuel, glucose. So with insulin resistance, okay, you eat this meal and you don't get fuel into the cell. So the cell lacks the energy, right? And if you don't have enough energy, boy, you just want to take a nap. You just kind of like, I'm just tired, right? So that's one reason why you might be tired. I'm going to get to a good solution, but glucose and insulin itself makes you tired. For example, if a diabetic takes too much insulin injection, they can actually get really, really, really tired mentally. They used to do a therapy called insulin shock therapy back in, I think, the 20s and 30s, where they would inject you with so much insulin, you go into a coma and you'd wake up fat, right? And they did this for mental problems, which is just crazy because it's barbaric to put someone in a coma to help them with their mental problems. Doesn't make sense. And then what happens when the insulin goes up, it pushes your glucose down. So you end up with low blood sugar sometimes, and that can make you tired as well. So it's what it's doing to your brain, right? It's just messing with your central nervous system, your brain. High sugar, low sugar, and then no fuel to the cells. Not good for your overall energy, especially your mental energy. But it's amazing what people do, especially what I've noticed in Europe for lunchtime, right after they eat. You know, they have to have a shot of espresso, maybe two, maybe three, with a little cigarette, and to keep them awake from the gelato or the bread or the wine that they just drank. Now, another reason why you might need to take a nap is let's say you just ate too much food, which basically happens is you have this shift of blood flow that goes from your brain to your gut. So now we have less blood flow in our brain, and we also have a stimulation of something called the parasympathetic nervous system, which is all about rest and digest. Okay, so your body's like ready to take a nap just from just too much food. It usually happens after a Thanksgiving meal, in America, but too much food can do that. Now let's add one other factor. Let's say, for example, you don't have enough hydrochloric acid in your stomach to digest that food. That can make you tired because you're getting a lack of digestion. So sometimes a simple addition of either apple cider vinegar before you eat and some water, like a tablespoon or two, can give you energy. So you might want to try that. Or even better yet, to take as a supplement, betaine hydrochloride. You might need to take 5, 6, 7, or 8, down that, drink that right before you eat. Especially if you're doing the Thanksgiving meal, you're going to find that you're going to be less tired and you'll have better digestion, less bloating. A good indication to know that you have low hydrochloric acid is that you get indigestion or bloating after eating, or maybe even acid reflux or heartburn or even GERD. That means you need more betaine hydrochloride and apple cider vinegar. Another reason why you're tired is you're not getting enough sleep at night. Okay. For years, I pushed myself because I did a lot of research, a lot of different things. So I'd get up extra early when I was in practice to be able to squeeze that in. So I'd be getting up at 4:30 and I'd probably get like 6 hours of sleep, which is just not enough. So that right there can make you tired in the midday. What I did to overcompensate is I took a nap. But now I try to get a little bit more sleep so I don't need a nap. But a lack of sleep will definitely make you tired. I created a video on sleep, a couple of them that are really good, recent ones. I'll put those down below if you don't sleep, because just that right there can just make a huge difference with your ability to maintain your energy through the entire day. So you can not have to take a nap after lunch or even mid-afternoon. Now, let's say, for example, it is mid-afternoon and you are tired. Some people get a snack to give them energy. That's a mistake, because now, guess what? You're going to jack up insulin, and now you're going to find you're going to be a little bit tired, let's say an hour and a half later, or you're going to be hungry an hour and a half later, because now we're messing up the blood sugars. These snacks are killer. What you want to do is you want to adapt to the ketones and then running your body on ketones. It's a much better fuel system and you won't be hungry between meals and you won't have a need for a snack. If you need a snack mid-afternoon, all that means is you're running on glucose and you're not running on ketones. And there is a really great way to get your body to run on ketones. And I will give you that link in a minute. If you're tired, don't go for food to wake you up. That's not the best thing to do. As far as another thing you can do, as a little kind of a hack, you can postpone the coffee that you drink in the morning, like push it up between 90 and 20 minutes later, okay? And that can actually help with that afternoon or after lunch dip in energy, because what caffeine does is it blocks this chemical compound called adenosine. And that makes you less sleepy. When you have adenosine that binds with your cells, that equals sleepiness. And this is why you have this at night. So if you take an antagonist to that or a blocker to that, like caffeine, it can actually make you less sleepy. That's what it does. And by delaying that process in the morning, that can help with the afternoon dip in energy. Now, one last thing that can make you kind of tired, and I'm talking mainly about tired through the whole day, it's called chronic fatigue syndrome. That's usually a deeper viral thing going on. That's some virus that you had long ago, like Epstein-Barr virus or something like that, that's been reactivated because of recent stress. So yes, there's a lot of different things you can take for viruses, but the most important thing is to get rid of whatever that stress is. Do something to improve it, and that will put that virus back in remission. And all of a sudden you'll have more energy. And also vitamin D will help as well. So number one, get on the healthy version of the ketogenic diet. And that includes doing intermittent fasting so you can adapt to fat fuel, the ketones, and then you actually can go between meals without that dip. Because if you're running on glucose, you're going to run out of energy real fast. If you're running on ketones, you have an almost unlimited amount of energy you can run on because it's fat fuel. So number one, get into ketosis. Number two, do whatever you can to improve your sleep. I'll put a link down below for that. Number three, delay that coffee in the morning by 90 to 120 minutes. And last point is to take some apple cider vinegar or betaine hydrochloride right before you eat to get more hydrochloric acid to digest that protein and other foods to help you prevent that sluggishness in your digestive system. All right, I think the best next video is this one on sleep. Check it out. I put it right here.